Because of the rising number of healthcare workers contracting COVID-19, consultants at the San Lazaro Hospital are also helping out in attending to patients. Last Friday, 148 healthcare workers tested positive for COVID.
Kulang po kasi na mga doktor, ang dami po nag-positive. So, nakaupo po kami mga consultants na po ang tumitingin na mga kagat ng aso. Yung mga pasyente po namin, tuloy pa rin po kahit ang daming nagpapaswab po sa kabila. So, swabbing area po sa kabila, dito naman sa amin, mga kagat ng aso po.
At the Dr. Josefa Belia Memorial Hospital, 112 patients are admitted for COVID infection. But 169 of healthcare workers there are positive and another 90 underwent COVID testing today. This prompted the hospital to limit their emergency room admissions. Their outpatient department closed for 2 weeks beginning January 7.
Pero ang malaking impact nga po dito would be that yung mga aming mga doktora na nag-oopera, yung mga aming obstetrician gynecologists, particularly, madami din po kasi sa kanila ang nag-positive.
Private hospitals are also feeling the brunt of rising COVID cases. The Private Hospitals Association of the Philippines tallies 15-member hospitals on critical occupancy with at least 85% or more occupancy. 20-member hospitals are labeled high-risk, having more than 70% occupancy. Occupancy are also increasing in private hospitals in Region 3 and 4. This is further aggravated by healthcare workers getting sick.
Pagka po nagkaroon pa ng pagkahawa o mabawasan pa itong ating mga healthcare workers, doon po tayo baka medyo mapilayan lalo ang ating mga hospital.
The Filipino Nurses United slammed the health department's decision to shorten the quarantine period for medical frontliners exposed to COVID-19. The group likened it to sending their members on a suicidal mission, when in fact, it says it's the government's responsibility to provide them a safe work environment and to reduce the risk of infection. The Alliance of Health Workers also decries the latest DOH directive.
Kahit sabihin niyo pa naka-PPE kayo during the sa duty mo, pero yung mga nakakasalamuha mo with sa pamilya mo or within the hospital, mahahawa din sila kahit asymptomatic ka pa.
The health department meanwhile defends its decision.
Department of Health will not issue this policy guidance if there is no evidence to support that. The Center for Disease Control of the United States have already implemented that also in the United States, wherein there is evidence really that fully vaccinated individuals and especially those with boosters have lower viral load than those unvaccinated and partially vaccinated. So having that as an evidence, we have adopted the CDC guidelines wherein we can be able to shorten the quarantine and isolation of our healthcare workers.
The health department also clarified the recommendation to shorten the quarantine period for health workers is still up to the discretion of the hospitals. Meanwhile, a government official apologized for the slow turnout of RT-PCR test results.
Unang rason po dyan is dami po talaga no, ng ating mga kababayan na nagpapatest. At ang pinakamabigat dito, marami po sa ating mga technician, mga medtech, mga laboratory technician ay nagpo-positibo din po at sila ay kinakailangang mag-isolate at hindi po sila nakakapag-report sa trabaho.
Zandro Ochona, ABS-CBN News.